Let's see, by a show of hands, how many of you are looking forward to our lunch today? All right. Now keep your hand up if you'd like to be able to eat lunch in 20 years. Okay, that's gonna be one, two, let's say just about everybody. My name is Katie Murphy, or as my students call me, the Corn Queen. And I'm working to ensure food for our future. The unfortunate reality is that 20 years from now, we expect 2 billion more people on this planet. That is 2 billion more mouths to feed. Given our current production levels, we simply cannot produce enough food. Lunch in the future could be a luxury. Now, my graduate research at UC Davis is working to solve this problem. How do we grow more food using less resources? We stop losing crops to plant disease. Just like humans, plants get sick, and when they do, our food dies in the field and never makes it to your plate. Now, the nasty, moldy ear of corn that you see up here is caused by a fungal disease. Fungus causes 10% crop loss of corn every year. Now, if we're not having a nice buttery ear of corn for lunch, I can guarantee you that we're eating something that was made with a corn byproduct, or we're eating something that has eaten corn. It is the backbone of the American food supply. What a 10% crop loss looks like is a cornfield that covers the entire state of Florida, rendered totally inedible. If we can rescue some of this crop from disease, we can grow more food. Now, my graduate research has uncovered a new group of chemicals that corn makes in response to this disease. Here, corn is acting as its own doctor, sensing that it's under attack, diagnosing itself with disease, and producing its own medicines, antibiotics, really, to fight off this fungus. Interestingly, we've only ever seen these chemicals in corn, not in any other plant. We now know the structure of these chemicals, the genes that control their production, and how they're working as antibiotics to fight off disease. I did so by taking the genes from corn and putting them into a bacteria that I can grow in the lab in order to make these chemicals and figure out what they do. Now that I have this knowledge of these naturally produced plant antibiotics, we can begin to reduce crop loss due to disease. Now, they do call me the Corn Queen, but I love all plants. And so using genetics and breeding, we can make corn varieties and other crops that can make their own medicines. This will reduce our current pesticide use, grow us more food, and generate stronger plants to ensure food for the future. Thank you.